يلا نبدأ.
بسم الله، تفضل.
شايف الشاشة؟
أيوة.
طيب، this is a 45 years old gentleman admitted to the medical assessment unit as he has been diagnosed with a large pulmonary embolus within the right pulmonary artery. He is requiring 2 liters of oxygen but hemodynamically stable. He has a previous history of PE. هذه 1 year ago المفروض ما تعدلت and was prescribed rivaroxaban at that time of the current and he is still on it.
معلش الصوت في صدى.
خلاص go ahead.
ما سمعت اخر جملة. And he's still on rivaroxaban.
Yeah.
طيب بسم الله. After introducing myself, take permission, identify patient, I will start with taking history of this newly diagnosed pulmonary embolus. What is the symptoms? What's the complaint? You complain since when? What increase? What decrease? Any associated symptom? Any other swelling? I will examine other swelling in the lower limb, both lower limb swelling, skin changes, hotness, redness, tenderness, any pain. Then I will ask the patient about any symptom of anemia, shortness of breath, palpitation, dizziness. Any symptom of other bleeding from other sites, orifice, skin. Then you ask about patient other risk factors of this embolism, like recent surgery, travel, prolonged immobilizations. I will go systematic review. If any CNS symptom, bearing of visions, headache, deficit, neurological deficit, what other chest symptoms, like any hemopsis, chest pain, coughing, shortness of breath, chest, any cardiac symptom of right side heart failure or strain, any abdominal pain symptom, fatigue, any satiety. I will also ask about any lumps. Then I'll ask about family history, any positive family history of same thrombosis. Then I will ask about past medical history in details, other than previous BE 1 year ago. What about diabetes, hypertension, autoimmune disease, any other hemolytic symptoms, like change in color of urine, changes in color, yellowish discoloration of skin. Then I will ask about history of, as I said, travel, blood transfusion, allergy, and any other medication than rivaroxaban. And of course, I will ask about the compliance of rivaroxaban.
Good, great. Bye. The patient had no obvious provoking factor, including symptoms and signs of autoimmune disease or malignancy. He has a previous history of PE 1 year ago, managed in HIL with heparin, then shifted to rivaroxaban and was still prescribed, still on it, prescribed at the time, till the time of the current presentation. He is compliant to his rivaroxaban, taking it appropriately with mean meal, and there is no other medication. He has no family history of thrombosis.
Examination?
Yes.
I will go for first general examination, any color, anemia, pallor, jaundice, cyanosis. Then I will get vital signs. What about oxygen saturation? He need two liters of oxygen. What about pulse, blood pressure, any hypotension, respiratory rate, of course. Then I will ask about height and weight, any dysmorphic features. Then I will examine systematically of the patient facial cyanosis or not, then chest examination, looking for any crepitation, decrease air entry, pleural effusion. I will examine cardiac, any gallop or murmur of or any bipulmonal, loud B component of the heart sound. Then I'll examine abdomen, any abdominal organomegaly. I'll examine, of course, the lymphadenopathy. I'll examine, of course, the lower limb for any sign or symptom of lower limb DVT. Other examination of the skin, joint, to rule out autoimmune disease. Of course, to rule out malignancy, other causes of BNH. CMS examination.
Great. Like examination, he's vital. He's hemodynamically stable, but his blood pressure is okay. Respiratory rate 22, pulse rate 120, saturation 95 and 2 liters. He's not in that distress. Cardiovascular cyst, abdomen examination were normal. No signs of lower limb DVT, no livedo reticularis.
Good.
Investigation?
So investigation we'll do for CBC with differential and peripheral blood morphology to check any abnormalities or fragmented RBCs. Of course, we can do blood probing and antibody identifications. We will go for coagulation profile, BTBTT, fibrinogen, D-dimer. Of any prolongation, we will check for mixing study with incubation. Then we'll go for complete metabolic panel. We'll see renal function, liver function test, electrolyte. Then we'll go for serology. Then we'll go for a specific symptom about what is the cause of second relapse, second embolism. Like we will go for investigation of BNH by flow, investigation of antiphospholipid by antiphospholipid antibody, anticardiolipin, beta-2 microglobulin, lupus anticoagulant. According to the CBC, if we need to do for MBN investigation or not, then we'll go for imaging study. Of course, he did already CTBE. We'll go if we need to do DVT Doppler ultrasound. If we need to do echo to see the stabilization of the cardiac strain or not, ECG, of course.
Okay. Beta 2 glycoprotein, not microglobulin.
Oh, sorry, beta 2 glycoprotein.
So his hemoglobin is 13.5, platelet 150. WBC 3.8, 1.9 neutrophils. Renal profile LFTs were normal. Coagulation mildly drained. His last dose of rifaximin was today AM. Lower limb Doppler, no DVT. CT abdomen of pelvis, no evidence of malignancy. Echo, normal. BNH and antiphospholipid screen in progress. Do you want to do a thrombophilia screen?
Yeah, this is a controversial question, but this patient, he already has two episodes of BE. He should have prolonged lifelong anticoagulant, so it will not change my management. So it's not mandatory to do it.
Good. So inherited thrombophilia screen not performed, has not going to change your management, and no family history with known disorder. How you'll manage this patient who developed BE or rivaroxaban?
Of course, acute, after stabilization of the patient.
He's stable.
And then I will start with acute phase. I will start as the patient is stable. We'll start with anticoagulation, mainly, of course, failure of rivaroxaban. I prefer to give heparin, better to low molecular weight heparin, therapeutic dose. I want to investigate why he developed another episode on rivaroxaban. Of course, there's no monitoring for rivaroxaban. I will start low molecular weight heparin.
Okay.
At the time, till the result will come out to see any abnormalities for antiphospholipid or what.
That? Anything else?
Well, this is the acute phase, low molecular weight heparin, then maybe shift to warfarin after 5 days. I mean, okay. Only bridging therapy, low molecular weight with heparin, with warfarin for 5 days till INR is 2 to 3, then continue warfarin. Then I will look for the result of the investigation.
Okay. So you managed him, you send him home on enoxaparin while being loaded on warfarin. However, he represented 3 days later, feeling awful with increasing shortness of breath. CTBA imaging confirms extension of his recent BE. He also has new renal and liver dysfunction. What's your potential differential diagnosis and what additional investigation would you want to at this stage?
So this patient, he has this exacerbation of the BE plus renal and liver dysfunction within 1 week. This patient maybe differential diagnosis of catastrophic AB antiphospholipid syndrome, mm-hmm. or he may have maybe he have head syndrome head after a low molecular weight heparin. So this is our differential diagnosis. I should be investigate both.
I mean, what you would like to send?
So I would like to send after already we sent already the antiphospholipid. So I will send the HIT ELISA antibody, mm-hmm. and of course I will change the warfarin. I will stop warfarin. I will change the enoxaparin to non-heparin anticoagulant like argatroban infusion. Of course, we will admit the patient, stabilize the patient, check the vital sign, everything, admit him. Then we start argatroban infusion.
Okay. So the patient continued to deteriorate following investigation now back. Hemoglobin 10, platelet 75, WBC 3.4, and neutrophils 1.6. Blood film, red cell fragments with infrequent spherocytes and polychromasia. High bilirubin, mainly conjugate, high LFTs. Urea and creatinine are high. INR 2.2. With a range and BNH is negative, JAK2 negative. Ultrasound liver suggestive of sinusoidal obstructive syndrome. CT abdominal pelvis, renal vein thrombosis. Would you like to send for HIT? What's his probability?
Yeah, his probability, his platelet, I don't remember. What was the platelet before?
150, now 75.
150, 75, yeah, 50%. This mm-hmm. will take two points. This is around 1 week post, I didn't see it.
How many days? 3 days
only. Mm. And 4 days, and the patient was, of course, was not exposed to heparin with the last 30 days, so we'll give zero, so only two. Another thrombosis. Will take two different. So he has other causes. Maybe we'll give possible other causes. One. So he has score 5 at least. So we'll send for ELISA. And of course, change to alternative other than non-heparin.
Okay. So we'll come to the calculation later. So his probability test was low. It was not sent. Lupus anticoagulant 2.1, normal ratio less than 1.2. IgG, IgM cardiolipin antibody low. IgA cardiolipin antibody 1,500, strongly positive. IgG beta 2 glycoprotein 347, positive.
So he
has
positive anticoagulant and positive beta 2 glycoprotein.
Okay.
Anticoagulant is negative and IgA is not counted.
Good. Your diagnosis now?
He's now, he of course, We need to repeat this lupus anticoagulant after 12 weeks to confirm. But okay. I will the patient at the time being as catastrophic antiphospholipid syndrome until proved otherwise.
Good. So the diagnosis is catastrophic antiphospholipid syndrome. What's the criteria for antiphospholipid syndrome, catastrophic antiphospholipid syndrome, and how you will manage this patient?
The criteria of antiphospholipid syndrome is a PARO criteria, which contain clinical, either thrombosis or pregnancy-related complications, and the laboratory, which contain the antibodies to be positive for at least 12 weeks, apart, two times, 12 weeks apart. The antibodies is lupus anticoagulant, anticardiolipin, and anti-beta-2 glycoprotein. The catastrophic antiphospholipid syndrome, we should have the antiphospholipid, of course. Then we should have at least three system or three organ affection within 1 week. And better to have a pathological diagnosis of microvascular thrombosis.
Okay.
How I will manage? This patient need to be managed. I didn't remember the management of catastrophic, but he need corticosteroid, dose of corticosteroid, IVIG, and some experts prefer to go for plasmapheresis. Of course, with continuation of anticoagulant.
Any role for steroids?
Yeah, I meant steroids, IVIG, plasmapheresis.
Plus anticoagulant.
Plus anticoagulant, yes.
Okay. What kind of anticoagulation?
Anticoagulation, of course, because patients have renal impairment, so in the acute phase, we'll start with unfractionated heparin. Loading dose, then infusion. We will follow the infusion. Of course, he has prolonged BCT at baseline, so he need to be followed by anti-10A for heparin.
Okay, good. كملنا.
الحمد لله.
بس يا عمو.
تسلم يا بركة. جزاك الله خير.
حياك. طيب
يلا
حنبدا بس بال طيب ريفيو بس للكيس قبل ما نسوي كومنتس. زي ما قلنا هذا البيشنت عنده سكند بولمونري امبوليزم وايل اون دواكس, سو كونسيدر فيلير اوف دواكس از هيستوري. You need to mention يعني about the acute onset the symptoms, what's the related symptoms. You need to search for risk factors. The past family history is very important, and what other medication he's on, and if there is any autoimmune disease related. تقريبا كلها ذكرت والexamination نفس الشيء كله ذكر. هذه من عندي الله يعطي العافية. نفس الكلام تقريبا الهيستوري الفيزيكال اكزامينيشن. You need to check everything as mainly risk factors, خاصة في الفيميل لو في pregnancy, OCBs, history of abortions, ممكن تكون دليل أكثر من الميل في الانفستيجيشن. طبعا أعطانا كل شيء تقريبا نورمال. الكواجليشن بروفايل كان عنده coagulopathy, most likely نتيجة ال rivaroxaban. You cannot differentiate if he has high BTT from the beginning or not. من the important thing in lower limb doppler, إذا ما كان عندنا diagnosis of PE, مثلا ما نقدر نسوي له CT ولا شيء, لازم نسوي doppler lower limb. Search for malignancy, هل هو appropriate في الايج هذا؟ طبعا لا, بس هي الكيس جاية ما في. BNH وانتيفوسفوليبيد should be screened for unusual recurrent thrombosis. الثرومبوفيليا سكرين زي ما قلنا ما نحتاجها الا في حالات معينه حنجي عليها بعد. الانفستيجيشنز سنت فور ايفريثينج بلاد فيلم مورفولوجي ليفر بانل بريجننسي تيست ابيو تايب سكرين يورين اكزام دي اي سي بانل لا تنساها هيت اذا عنده انترميديت تو هايبربوليتي الهيموليسيس بانل الفايرال انتي فوسفوليبيد سكرين اوتوميون بانل ثرومبوفيليا ورك اب اف انديكيتد تشيست اكس راي سي تي بي اي دور لم دوبلر الترا ساوند ابدومين فور ميجرين تقريبا او برين سي تي.
عفوا يزيد السلايد تحركها ولا لان ثابته عندي الباوربوينت
تحرك معاكم ولا لا؟
لا
انا
مبهرت لا ما
تتحرك صراحه فكرناك استغربت يلا
دقيقه شايفين هذه تمام كذا ممتاز يلا
هذه زي ما قلنا الهيستوري والاكزامينيشن الانفستيجيشن الانهيريتد ثرومبوفيليا سكرين نت بيرفورمد از نت جوينج تو تشينج يور مانجمنت عنده ريكرنت ثرومبوسيس فهيز فور لايف لونج انتيكوغوليشن نو فاميلي هيستوري ود نون ديسوردر اولسو. اذا قال لك طب اذا يمديك ترسل وات يو كان دو اذا البيشنت على انتيكوغوليشن او في اكيوت ثرومبوتيك ستيج اونلي الفايف فاكتور 5 ليدن والبروثرومبين جي ميوتيشن يو كان سند ات بيكوز اتس serology test اما الاذرز يو كان نت اللي هو البروتين اس وسي والانتي ثرومبوفيليا indication for thrombophilia workup patient with family history of VTE first degree relative under the age of 45 young age يعني patient without family history of VTE اذا كان young patient with recurrent thrombosis not on anticoagulation patient with thrombosis in multiple venous sites زي البورتال هيباتيك unusual sites يعني patient with hepatic portal vein thrombosis look for JAK2 will be in it mainly patient with a history of warfarin induced skin necrosis look for protein C deficiency و arterial thrombosis mainly the ABS hemocysteine طبعا ال VNH can do it will JAK2 can do it management هو كان stable وانت الان في قرارها لانه inpatient ولا outpatient what's your choice of anticoagulation and duration وهل هو does he need to bridge while switching ولا لا education about side effects bleeding and the interaction with food and his follow up طيب the patient was stable ما عنده اي indication انه to be managed as inpatient زي massive PE extended iliofemoral DVT significant comorbidities cardiovascular respiratory bleeding disorder ما عنده او انه cannot be anticoagulated for you think of other major like IVC filter او عنده renal impairment عبال ما تعدل الدوزز وكل شيء بعدين you can discharge choice هو كان على دواك والان مالك اللي ترجع للورفرين duration for lifelong does he need bridging yes لانه الدواكس كانت مسويت لك elevating لل INR وهو كان عنده acute thrombus ما تبغى تخليه without anticoagulation for any period. Side effects مع الورفرين CNS bleed أكثر. Many interactions with the antibiotics mainly and avoid the greens. طبعا بالكميات الكبيرة الكميات الصغيرة ما عندنا مشكلة. Follow up period quickly follow up in anticoagulation clinic till plateauing of the INR between 2 to 3. Then it can be spaced فترات أطول. طبعا انا هرسل لكم بي دي اف عن السويتشنج هذا انا لقيت اكثر من واحد بعضهم يقول لك ما يحتاج وبعضهم يقول لك يحتاج بس انا اي ثينك هي نيد انه يكون في عنده اذر ايجنت فور بريدجنج فهنا كاتب لك سويتشنج فروم وورفرين فروم ريفركسيبان تو وورفرين ستوب ريفركسيبان ستارت وورفرين اند كونسيدر ستارتنج بريدجنج ايجنت ات ذا نيكست ريفركسيبان ديو تايم Start INR monitoring 2 days after stopping the rivaroxaban. Stop the bridging agent once the INR is achieved. طبعا قلنا he was sent home ورجع لنا ب progression of his B. Differential diagnosis هذه أخذتها من article how to treat catastrophic thrombotic presentation. فلو ما نبغى نسميها antiphospholipid catastrophic antiphospholipid syndrome من البداية نسميها catastrophic and thrombotic presentation. في من differentials. فacute onset of multiple thrombolic event تأخذ history physical exam ولابس. Clinical data not suggestive of malignancy ولا suggestive of malignancy. Not suggestive. Additional diagnostic laboratory test عندك الماها to look for a TTB ولا other TMAs. Antiphospholipid catastrophic ABS إذا normal idiopathic catastrophic thrombotic events أو thrombocytopenia for the head. إذا كان ما عنده suggestive of malignancy to look for malignancy cancer thrombosis syndrome. Negative ترجع لل كان نفسه. طب رجع لنا باللابس عنده البليتلت 75 تقريبا 50% reduction not more. وعندنا هاي كرياتينين عندنا multiple organ affection. فالهيت لو بتحسبها حتطلع 3. عندنا 1 30-50% platelet decrease من 150 ل 75 50% بالضبط. إذا أكثر 2 التايمينج اوف انست أقل من 4 أيام فتعطيه 0 وما عنده أي recent exposure عنده قبل 1 year only. الثرومبوسيس عنده new thrombosis ولا عنده progressive recurrent thrombosis عنده progression في الثرومبوسيس فهذه 1 other causes possible فهذه 1 1 1 3 فهو low probability يعتبر. طبعا الهيت السي في الانتيجين السي وفي الفانكشنال السي. الانتيجين السي انتي بي 4 والاليزا عندها high false positive rate but high negative predictive value. اما الفانكشنال السي فهي diagnostic have high sensitivity و specificity. فهذه أخذتها من الـ British Guidelines. إذا عندك Clinical Suspicions طبعاً إذا High سوي الأنتيجين أسي Positive High Titer Confirmed. إذا Low Titer Consider Functional Assay Negative Exclude. بالنسبة للLow إذا Positive Consider Functional Assay But if, إذا Low Titer أو Negative Exclude. والIntermediate على حسب يعني. What's the criteria of ABS, catastrophic ABS, and how you manage? من up to date, طبعاً كلنا عارفين المفروض. Vascular thrombosis, malignancy morbidity, أكثر من نقطة. مع one laboratory, one and one. Catastrophic ABS, عندنا evidence of involvement of three or more organs, development of manifestation of in less than 1 week, confirmed histopathology, at least one organ or tissue. Laboratory confirmation of antiphospholipid antibody. Definitive requires all four criteria. Probable or four except only two organs. يعني فيها defect. Management, it's a multidisciplinary team approach. Hematologist, ICU, blood bank. You need to stabilize the patient, ICU team consult, treatment generally directed for thrombotic events and suppressing the cytokine this cascade. Combination of anticoagulation with unfractionated heparin till stabilization then to shift to warfarin. Systemic steroids, methyl bred 0.5 gram to 1 gram for 3 days, pulse steroid. Yani. Plasma exchange, no specific duration, but recommended 5 sessions. هل with albumin ولا with FFB؟ الستدي اللي كانوا مسوينها كان فيها 250 patient اللي سووا لهم بلازما exchange كانت with FFB بس ما هم عارفين ايش الافكت حق الالبومين لان ما في اي ستدي على الشيء هذا. IVIG 400 milligram per day for 5 days to start on the last day of plex to avoid the removal of the immunoglobulin. If refractory Consider other lines like rituximab, eculizumab, and cyclophosphamide. هذا طبعا زي الابروتش للكابس anticoagulate with unfractionated heparin and steroids, assist treat precipitating factor like infection malignancy. هل عنده systemic lupus erythematosus ولا لا؟ طبعا no, شوف للorgan. Yes, consider cyclophosphamide. اذا no, organ threatening. Yes, go for plasma exchange. Clinical improvement. No, consider rituximab. Yes, taper immunosuppression and switch to oral anticoagulant. إذا ما في أي organ threatening, clinical improvement, yes, روح للimmune, taper immunosuppression and switch to oral anticoagulant. No, go for plasma exchange. خلصنا تقريبا الكلام بس بشكل عام عن الانتيفوسفوليبيد prevention. هل هو primary the patient عنده positive antiphospholipid antibody with no history of thrombosis for primary prevention هل نسوي له primary prevention ولا لا؟ يعتمد على الريسك stratification حقه age antiphospholipid antibody profile risk factor of thrombosis other systemic autoimmune disease if only ABL aspirin versus no prevention recommendation أن to follow the cardiac guidelines for aspirin use Secondary prevention, إذا عنده history of venous thrombosis, warfarin only is enough. إذا arterial, warfarin plus ASA أو aspirin. طبعا TRAPS trial showed أنه الدواكس has increased arterial and venous thrombosis comparing to warfarin في triple positive antiphospholipid antibody. ف يعطيك انه الوفرين يقول لك don't use it في الانتيفوسفوليبيد الدواكس يقول لك although it's not powered but even a non triple positive antibody rivaroxaban was not non inferior to warfarin يعني حتى ما وصل للوفرين في النون تريبل طبعا انا ما اعتقد انه الجدول هذا ابدا واضح عندكم بس هذا من الـ New England Journal of Medicine اللي هو الارتكل اللي في 2018 عن الانتيفوسفوليبيد حارسله بصورة أوضح بعدين هو يتكلم عن كل medication و when you can use it و الافكت تبع طب what about الobstetrical antiphospholipid أنا أخذت هذه من انضياء أرسل لي برضو البرزنتيشن حق البورد ريفيو الهيستوري اوف obstetric complications إذا عنده patient go with low doses aspirin with prophylactic dose low molecular weight heparin for the entire pregnancy and 6 weeks post delivery طبعا based on a weak evidence pregnant woman with thrombotic antiphospholipid syndrome low dose aspirin and therapeutic dose low molecular weight regardless of their obstetric history positive antibody with no thrombotic or obstetric complication only aspirin enough Woman with antiphospholipid syndrome with OB event, obstetric events, but no thrombotic ones. The risk of thrombosis is higher in their age and gender matched to no OBS. Outside pregnancy and beriberium, no recommendation for long-term anticoagulation. The approach هذا من up to date. إذا عندك pregnant woman postpartum, or postpartum women with persistent antiphospholipid positivity. هل البيشنت عندها thrombosis ولا لا? Yes, then anticoagulate, antipartum therapeutic dose plus low dose aspirin. Postpartum, you can shift to warfarin indefinitely. No history of thrombosis. Has the patient has any ABS defining pregnancy morbidity? Yes or no? No. Antithrombotic management with low dose aspirin for the antipartum period. Postpartum, use vaginal delivery, intermittent pneumatic compressions with low dose aspirin. Caesarean delivery, prophylactic dose, low molecular weight, and low dose aspirin for 6 weeks. And the defining event, pregnancy event, a type. More than one fetal losses at 10-week gestation or unexplained consecutive spontaneous pregnancy loss less than 10 weeks. Use antithrombotic management for antibiotic prophylactic dose, low molecular weight, heparin plus aspirin. Postpartum, the same thing regardless of the route of delivery. والله عندها لا one more than one preterm delivery of a morphologically normal infant before 34 weeks due to severe preeclampsia, eclampsia or other defining other findings. هتعطيها antithrombotic management, most cases antibiotic only aspirin. Postpartum نفس نظام إذا ما عندها أي pregnancy development. Vaginal delivery, pneumatic compression plus low dose aspirin. Cesarean, low dose aspirin plus prophylactic low molecular weight heparin. وهذا نفس الشيء من الجدول up to date. بحط لكم بس ويعطيكم العافية.
جزاك الله خيرا.
الله يعطيك العافية زيد. يعطيك العافية أبو عبد الرحمن.
بارك الله فيك حبيبي.
تفضل وأي كومنت.
معلش ممكن الشريحة اللي قبل دي على طول. أيوه. انزل تحت وين كده. إيه الفرق بين في آخر 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 حاجة تحت اللي هو type of antiphospholipid defining pregnancy morbidity. إيه الفرق بين الاثنين يعني؟ More than one fetal loss after 10 weeks, more than one preterm delivery, or morphologic normally infant. هما الاثنين يعتبروا pregnancy related morbidity, صح؟
Yes.
الفرق يعني عارف. إيش معنى دي بتاخد warfarin؟ Sorry, low molecular وهذه لا.
أنا أعتقد إنه duration حقة ال pregnancy نفسه وال cause of loss of pregnancy.
يعني ده يعني مور ميلي بري إكلامسيا وإكلامسيا فبيستفيد من الأسبرين دون أمشي أسبرين خلاص ماشي فهمت تمام شكرا
بس أعتقد هذا الشيء تعرف يحبون يفسرون
تمام تمام شكرا
يعطيك العافية
طبعا
يعطيك العافية دكتور يزيد.
ما يعافيك.
بس ممكن سؤال ممكن لما إجا بالسكند ثرومبوسيز على ريفاروكسيبان ممكن it worth إنه نبعث الأنتي فاكتور 10 تبع الريفاروكسيبان if available at the lab.
نعمل.
الأنتي فاكتور 10.
هنا.
أيوة.
أنتي فاكتور 10 levels on readmission was 0.2. Yes, you can. That's like for that scenario, you can do it. But so, حط لك في السيناريو إنه he is compliant to it. Yeah.
Uh-huh. طيب شغلة ثانية بالكاتاستروفيك من ضمن اللاب صح لازم نبعث للأدم 13.
Yeah. Everything. عندك الكاتاستروفيك ثرومبوتيك تبعثين لكل شيء. هذا الديفرنشال. TTB, you send for all Adams TS13, you send for all HETIDA indicated with ABS.
Does it worth in order to involve the rheumatology also? عشان نعرف إنه مثلا ممكن this patient was having يعني missed SLE مثلا clinical evaluation before. لأنه كتريتمنت differ حسب ما أنت حكيت صح؟ إذا كانت البيشنت يعني fulfilling the SLE criteria. Yeah, yeah. كانت سكندري من بلش سايكل فوسفامايد صح؟
فاهمك أنا إياه yes الدفر أنه هنا حاطين لك إياه أنه to start cycle فوسفامايد خاصة أنه هذه ترى من أرتكل حقة روماتولوجي يعني نفسه
أوكي
بس ما أدري في الأكيوت event ممكن الاستابليزيشن حيكون نفس الشيء أوكي صح هنا كاتب أنه yes بس انت ما عندك يعني هنا هل في سيستميك لوبس إريثيماتوسس ما حيمديك تنتظرين على ما تطلع الريزلت كامله فيمكن أنك you go with no till مثلاً you evolve the rheumatology.
ومعلش أنا لأنه مش كثير ركزت بالكرايتيريا تبع الأنتي فوسفوليبيد. We need to do tissue biopsy للباسكولايتس صح ولا لا؟
Yes. بالكرايتيريا حق الكاتاستروفيك قصدك.
أيوة بالكاتاستروفيك.
Yes. We need. أساس تكون ديفينيتيف.
أوكي.
اللي هي هنا. Confirmation by histopathology for small fissures inclusion in at least one organ tissue. Just to make it definite.
Criteria يعني هي راح تكون probable إذا ما عملناهاش بس.
Yes.
أوكي. شكراً يعطيك العافية.
تعليق ثاني يا شباب. هذا الهدوء يخوف.
الله يعطيك العافية يزيد.
دكتور صلاح كان شوي عامل لنا جو.
صح فارق صلاح.
أخوت قيمته يعني.
طيب انا ممكن بس عامل برزنتيشن باوربوينت عشان ال bleeding on anticoagulant approach فانا بس راح ابعث
ما في ريكوردينج
تمام
يعني احنا لو خلصنا في احد عندكم اول